Hello, thank you for inviting me to this conversation. I'm Chanok Pon Pua Pattanakul, or you can call me May. I'm the director of the Center for Life Integrated Learning at Mahidol University, Thailand. Our center is responsible for delivering the general education courses to Mahidol students and promoting seamless integration of learning into every aspect of life. So mostly our dedication lies in helping people learn important skills, preparing individuals for workforce, and promoting continuous learning opportunities. We support a wide range of individuals, including our students, alumni, corporate partners, and professional organizations, and also the general public. By making quality learning resources openly accessible, we give people the tools they need to grow and do well in the changing world, right? So it's about making sure that everyone can start their own learning journey, the journey that fits their starting point and fits their goals and also their pace of learning. And so for Thailand, open education help people who are looking for work or better job opportunities, as well as people who want to advance in their careers or even secure their current one. And it also helps the elderly and people in disabilities, kids who are dropping out of school, especially after pandemic, right? So help them to get the right learning materials at the right place at the right time. Improve the influence of open education in Thailand and also at Mahidol University. The first thing is I've been witnessing the emerging of learning platform lately. Like at Mahidol, we have like three different platforms to fit three different styles of learning and three target groups of learners. Like we have MUX platform for formal and non-formal education. We have Mahidol University Continuing Education Learning Platform for continuing education, which aims to fit professional learning. And we have Mahidol Channel Academy platform, which is more like edutainment platform for informal education. The second thing is co-creating education. So we're teaming up with businesses and professional groups and NGOs to create courses and programs that really hit the mark, like in terms of what skills are really needed out there in the workplace. And a lot of these programs are even backed by government funds, like non-degree program in Thailand, which is great. It's all about connecting education directly to jobs and career opportunities and make sure that what students or learners learn truly open doors for them. The next thing is collaboration between universities and educational institutions. Like we are also working closely with other universities, both in Thailand and abroad. For example, we have like Thailand General Education Network, and together we are sharing courses and resources and make it easier for students from different universities to pick up credit and learn from like broader spectrum or subjects. In Thailand, we are also developing the supporting system called National Credit Bank System, where students can mix and match their learning experiences from different universities and from formal, non-formal, or even informal learning. And it all counts towards their education when it's needed. And the last thing is international collaboration. Like we are engaging in international network, like partnerships, such as AUNTPL, to learn from global best practices in open education. So this includes participation in global networks and forums and conferences, which are dedicated to open education. I think building a collaborative ecosystem is a very crucial one. Like by sharing resources and expertise, we can develop more complete and accessible educational resources. And another benefit of this kind of collaboration is that it keeps us from doing the same job and allows us to focus more on what we can do well, focus more on our strength and fulfill each other. The second thing is, I think we need to conduct more research on open education. We need to to understand the impact of open education and identify area of improvement, right? And for local impact, I think, well, why we aim for international impact, it's also important that open education should remain locally relevant. Like it, for example, we should find some content that relevant to local languages, cultures, and social needs. And this also includes getting around language barriers by translating and making material with maybe AI or machine learning. So in this way, we make sure that open education not only touches like many people, but also keep them open to those people in the local countries. Like, so it can connect to people with their real life experiences and goals. We are all aware that open education is important, right? However, it's always challenging to demonstrate and convince other people that our job is worth supporting, especially financially support. So how do you measure the impact on reducing inequalities and increasing access to knowledge? And what are the key areas of improvement or areas of opportunities or growth for open education?